Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to use the remaining plugins in SoundBridge. The plugins featured in this video are the Noise Gate, Limiter, Compressor, Reverb, Filter Unit, and EQ. Before starting this video, make sure you've checked out the rest of the series so you're all caught up. The first plugin we'll cover is the Noise Gate, which can be used to reduce noise when the track doesn't reach a threshold. The first control at the top is to link channels. If this is enabled, the noise gate acts on both the left and right channels in the same way. If it's disabled, it processes them independently. Below that, we have the input control. The default is for a noise gate to be controlled by the track that it's processing, but it can also be controlled by a sidechain, which means another track determines when the noise gate opens. To change that track, press the button on the right that says None and select the other track. If we leave it at None, it will be controlled by the track that it's on. We can also change whether it analyzes the signal pre-effects, post-effects, or post-mix, which includes the fader. The next option is for the look-ahead, which allows the noise gate to analyze the signal a few milliseconds before and start opening faster, that way nothing gets cut off at the beginning. The slider is used to set the threshold. The threshold determines the level at which the noise gate allows the signal to pass through. The attack sets how fast this happens when the threshold is reached, and the release is how fast the gate closes when the signal drops below the threshold. Finally, we have a gain knob to adjust the level after processing. The next plugin we'll look at is the limiter. Limiters act to boost the levels of a track to the threshold, but they can't go beyond it due to their unlimited ratio. Once again, we have a link channels button and a look ahead. The threshold slider sets the level it will be limited to. The attack sets how quickly it's limited, and the release is how fast it drops back down. The gain is how much gain is applied after the processing. If you want to get a loud track without much dynamic range, you would set the threshold low so that it's brought down to that level whenever it passes it, and then use the gain knob at the end to bring the volume back up. Our next plugin is the compressor, but it can also work as an expander by pressing the compressor button at the top to switch mode. The compressor and expander also has a link channels button, look ahead, and input control with a sidechain. The threshold sets the level the compressor acts at. If the signal goes past this level, the compressor will reduce it based on the ratio which is set at the bottom. A ratio of 1 causes no change. A 3-to-1 ratio decreases a level that's 3 dB above the threshold to 1 above. The attack and release control how fast the compressor starts and stops the gain reduction. Once again, we have a gain control at the end. One of the most complex plugins we have in this program is the reverb. Reverb creates space in our track by simulating the reflection of the sound off the walls. The first button is for the quality. If we have it set high, then it sounds better, but the CPU usage is higher. The freeze pauses the reverb so we can hear what it sounds like. Reverb time determines how long the reverb lasts, and steepness is how fast it decays. Diffusion adjusts how the echo sounds, ranging from blurry to clear and fluttery. Bass boost can be used to add to the low frequencies. The high cut sets the cutoff frequency, and the high cut amount determines the amount of signal reduction. In the next row, we have early reflections level, the balance of early and late reflections, the late reflection gain, the pre-delay, liveliness, and wet signal. The filter unit is used to cut or filter out certain frequencies. On the left, we have a low pass, which removes the high frequencies. Then we have a high pass that removes the low frequencies. The bandpass reduces both the high and low frequencies, and the notch filter cuts the level at a certain frequency. With the filter unit, we can only have one band enabled at a time, and we can switch between them at the top. Each band has a frequency control and a cue to adjust the width and shape of the band. The last plugin we'll cover is the equalizer. This is used to adjust the levels of the frequencies on a track. From left to right, we have a low shelf, four bands, and a high shelf. Each band can be enabled by clicking on its button. They each have a frequency level, gain that can be boosted or cut, and a cue to adjust the width and shape. Pressing the button on the top right toggles the frequency analyzer on and off, and the frequency analyzer is post-EQ, so it shows us what changes we've made. When bands are enabled, we can drag them left or right to change the frequency, up or down to change the gain, and we can drag the arrows to change the cue. Thanks for checking out this video on the plugins available in SoundBridge. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for links to social media accounts to stay up to date on all our new content.